Hello and welcome back. We have learned how to create and manage a database on a worksheet. In that process, we have learned how to add a record and avoid duplicates, search for data, update the data, display an image of the, let's say, employee or student, and we can also clear the data that we have entered here. Today we will learn about navigation through records. So how do we go to the first record? Now, if I click on this button here, you see I've come to the first record, which is here on row 13. If I click on the last record, go to last row or last record, then I've come here to the last record, which is Ram Kapoor. Okay, then let us say if I am at the last record and I want to go to the next record, then I get a message, you are now in the last row, which is fine. Okay, so if I go back, I will come to the second last record. Now, how do we code such buttons that will help us to go to the next record, to the record earlier, or go to the first record, or to go to the last record? So let's go to the developer tab, Visual Basic. So yeah, I have the code for going to the next record. The first thing we do is we check for the first row. We know which is the first row. So let's go to back to our Excel worksheet, and this is our first row of data, which is in row 13. Therefore, we assign the first row the value 13, and we declare at the top what the first row is, first row as long. Similarly, we declare a last row and assign it the value using the find method. Now, once we have done that, we also assign the value that is in cell A4, that is row 4 and column 1, to a variable called current row, which is declared here at the top. Okay, so when you go here, you see in cell A4 we have the value 27 at present. So that is how we capture that value, which is here. And normally you can hide this by going to home and using a white font. Okay, but to show you how we are working, I am showing this row value to you, or the cell value to you, which you can use for the current row to navigate through the different values. So let's go back to our developer tab, Visual Basic. Now, once we have the last row value, which you can get by just giving out a message box that will give you the last row, we have the first row also, assign the value 13 as you saw. Then the current row is assigned the value which is in cell A4 or range A4. Now what do? We say if the current row is greater than or equal to first row, then alone we will go to the next row. And that's another condition, that means the current row should be less than the last row, because once we are in the last row and we click next record, we cannot go to another record because there is no more record. So the on click of that button here, next, the first thing we do is we say, after applying the condition, we say current row is assigned the value current row plus 1. That means if we were in row 13, now we will now go to row 14, and then we will take the values from the current row and the relevant column and assign it to our range at the top. You see here, so you can see that Louis White is in row 27 and Louis, the first name, is in row 3, and that is assigned to the range E2 here. Okay, similarly the last name is assigned to the range E3, and so on. So this data is assigned to these ranges and we get our data. After we have applied this condition, we assign the current row to our range A4. For example, if I now click on back, let's say, I'll just keep on clicking. So I am in some area, 15, I'm in 15, which is here. So when I go to the next row, I'm in row 16, so I assign that value, the current row value, to that cell. Finally, if the current row is assigned the value of the last row, then we give out a message, you are now in the last row. Okay? This is very interesting code, and when you use it, you'll understand the value of this code. Now let us go to our code for the back one. So if I click on back now, it will go to Kate Martin, and if I click back again, it will go to Harry Kali, as you can see. Okay, so how is that code constructed? In a very similar manner to the next row, here we also assign the last row value using the find method. Then we assign the first row value 13, because that's where our data starts. We assign the value of the area where we are. Let's say I was here in 14. Then I assign this value to the current row. After that, I apply a condition. If current row is greater than first row, because once we are in the first row and I click back, I wouldn't be going anywhere, isn't it? So the current row must be greater than the first row, and the current row must also be less than equal to the last row. Then we do the following. That means if you are in the current row, then reduce that by 1. That means go back and then assign the relevant values from the current row and the relevant column to the cells that we have seen above. That means, let's say Harry Kali. So assign this value to this range and this value to this range, and the number here, for example, to this range. Looks easy once you read this, but when you apply this, you will understand how important it is to do this step by step. After we have applied the condition, what we need to do is give the value of the current row to the cell here, which we are always referring to. Okay. Finally, we give out a message. If current row is equal to first row, then we say you are now in the first row. So you need not keep on clicking and saying I want to go back. So once you are in row 13, we give out a message, you are now in the first row. Okay, so let's go back to Visual Basic and let's look at the method to go to the first row. Now that is of course very easy, because we declare a first row and we assign it the value 13, because that is where our data starts. And then we take the value from the first row and the relevant column and assign it to the ranges in E2 to E9. Okay, that's pretty easy. Now let's look at the code for the last row. That is very similar to the first row. So we have module 10 here, and you can see here, for the back button or for the button where we are going to the last row, we again declare our last row here. Then the last row and the column is assigned to the relevant cell and we get our data. So these four buttons, they make the navigation through data very easy. Now you must be wondering how I created these buttons. So if you don't know, let me tell you. You go to Insert, you go to Illustrations, go to Shapes, and you can select the buttons. For example, this button here I have selected, Arrow Pentagon. And if you click on this, then you can click and drag, and you can format this. You can fill the shape with different colors. For example, if you wanted red, you could fill it with red. You can give a shape outline, so you can give a blue outline if you want it. You see there is a blue outline, and if you wanted to increase the weight, so you could make it thicker, for example, like this. Similarly, you could give out shape effects. You can see here presets. You could give out with something like a shade here. Do you notice that? You can use a shadow if you wanted, something like this, or something like this. You can use reflection. So there are a number of different options that you can use to make your buttons look more beautiful. Then finally you click inside this and you can write your caption, for example, next. Okay, you can select it, you can make it bold, you can increase its size or decrease its size, and in this manner you create a button. Once you have created this button, you can right click on it, go to assign macro, and you can assign it to the appropriate macro that you have created in your VB editor. So for this next one, go to next record, okay, and we say okay here. And you can see when I click here, now we are here in the first row. If I click on it, it will go to Harry Carly, and next Kate Martin, and so on. I hope you found this interesting and useful. Thanks for watching.